lonely little freshman girl. And so wanted a place where I could just meet some people, do something fun that I had never tried before. Found out about Hollow for Hunger through my sorority, AFI, and because a lot of the girls were involved in that. And they said, you know, come try it, you'll like it. And of course, came and loved it, loved the atmosphere, loved meeting new people, and got to be involved with Hillel. So.
And then there's this idea of SMU, which is modesty, where women, there's the idea that women have to cover themselves. But SMU and modesty is really for both men and women. And it's to preserve the integrity of the relationship between a man and a woman who are married.
My brother said that you should go to Hillel because there's free dinner every Friday night, but I didn't anticipate to be as involved as I am, but I'm glad that I did end up getting so involved. Yes, it was Reform Services. I ended up going a few times because I felt bad just coming for dinner, so I went to services as well. I really enjoyed them, and I ended up becoming like a regular, one of the people that would show up almost every week. And at the end of the year, they asked me if I wanted to lead Reform Services. And I said, sure. I thought that would be a really good time.
It really just depends. I mean, it's a mix of girls and guys, a mix of people from Greek life and not from Greek life. We generally ask people to introduce themselves at the beginning. And I mean, you hear people of all four grades and graduate school majors. Often parents are in town or community members who want to be a part of the service. And we have engineers, scientists, liberal arts majors, and we definitely have a wide range of participants, which is very interesting for a service. And it's cool to have that challenge as a leader to try and cater to each of these different backgrounds, different needs, and different interests.
You know, it's so important to have a Jewish connection wherever you go. And for, you know, for a lot of the students at UT, this is the first time people are in their extended period away from home. And it's that first opportunity to really try to make a decision about what role Judaism is going to play in your life moving forward.
The reasons for which how they would connect to God. And as in their struggle, they come to the conclusion that this isn't something that I can necessarily prove or deal with. But they're still living a Jewish life. Could they still be a Jew?
Many years later, fast forward, many years later, there was famine in the land of Canaan. In Israel, there was famine, and the brothers, Jacob and the children, the family were starving, hungry. And they heard that there was lots of food in Egypt. They come to Egypt looking for food, and they're standing next to the ruler of Egypt, pleading for some food to take back to Canaan. Who are they standing next to? Their brother Joseph.
Really, we go to great lengths to make sure that Jewish values and learning are included in basically everything we do. You know, Challah for Hunger, we're talking about hunger and homelessness, and what does that mean to be baking challah when so many people don't have enough to eat?
We've given them the tools, we've given them the confidence, we've given them an orientation to how to be involved in the greater Jewish community through our mentor programs, the people who are professionals out there and are great role models as to how to be involved in the Jewish community. I think we build that bridge so that they can walk over the bridge and know how to start when they leave Texas Hill. I think that's one of the most important things that we can do here at Texas Hill is to build that bridge so they're ready to be involved in the Jewish community, and they know where to start.